Hi everyone! Today, I'll walk you through this marketing dashboard designed to help you visualize how your campaigns are performing in the fiscal year across different cities and marketing platforms. Let me show you around. Starting from the top left, you'll see the title Marketing Dashboard. Just below that, there's a row of fiscal year selectors. For our sample data, it runs from FY 2021 to FY 2025. To access the additional years, simply click the right arrow at the end of the row. And you can also click on any fiscal year to instantly refresh the entire dashboard to show only that year's data. To the left, you'll see clickable icons for Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. These let you drill down the dashboard by platform. For example, selecting TikTok narrows everything down to TikTok-related campaign data. At the center, there's an interactive map with the red dots representing where your campaigns are running. And beside the map, there's a quick snapshot showing the overall number of likes, shares, and comments across all campaigns. Hovering over a red dot will display the engagement metrics specific to that region. And if you click on the dot, the dashboard will drill down to show just that region's performance. Now, I'll reset the filters and take you to the lower half of the dashboard, which is divided into four key visuals. Let's start from the left, the Return on Ad Spend by Campaign chart. It compares performance across the three campaign types: brand development, content marketing, and product marketing. The bars in red show the selected fiscal year, while gray represents the prior year. This visual makes it easy to spot year-over-year changes and see which campaigns are delivering the strongest returns. You can also click on any campaign to drill down into that campaign-specific results across the dashboard. Next is the engagement rate trend. This line chart shows the monthly engagement rate for the selected year in red and the previous year in gray, which is consistent with the earlier visual. This visual is great for identifying seasonal patterns, spotting dips, or confirming whether a new strategy is working. To the right is the clicks by device type chart, showing total clicks split between desktop and mobile for the selected fiscal year. It gives a quick snapshot of where your audience is most active. And clicking on either slice will filter the dashboard to that device type too. Lastly, we have the ad level performance metrics, highlighting impressions, click-through rate, spend, and conversion value for each ad. It's perfect for comparing results side by side, and you can drill down to focus on any specific ad, giving you data you can act on right away. This dashboard brings all your marketing insights together in one simple and interactive view. If you like what you're seeing so far, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, let me show you how to make this dashboard yours in three simple steps. Step 1. Download the template. Start by downloading the Power BI template and the Excel dataset using the link in the description below. It's completely free and easy to access. After downloading, extract the files from the zip folder, and you're done with step 1. Step 2. Replace the dataset. Now, let's open the Excel file. We'll start with the fiscal year setup. In the Parameters worksheet, use the drop-down to select the start month of your reporting period. The file will automatically populate the fiscal end month below. Take note of the end month number highlighted in green, as you'll need this later when updating the BI file. The next worksheet fiscal year updates automatically based on your selection at the Parameters worksheet. No changes are required here. In the Data worksheet, you'll find the campaign data. Everything is neatly organized in a single sheet, making updates quick and straightforward. It includes all the key fields such as campaign city, campaign type, platform, ad name, device, numbers of impressions, likes, shares, comments, clicks, conversions, as well as conversion value and spend amount. Simply replace the sample data with your own records. Once the data is updated, your Excel file is ready to go. Step 3. Load your data to the BI template. Open the BI file in the Power BI desktop. If you don't have Power BI desktop yet, download it free from the Microsoft website. The link is in the description. I'm also putting together a time-lapse video showing how this dashboard was built, and I'll add the link above once it's ready. Now, back to loading your data. Click on the Transform Data button to enter the query view. Then go to Data Source Settings at the top. Select the file shown, click on Change Source. Browse and navigate to the folder where you saved your dataset. Power BI file will then load your updated data automatically. While still in the query view, let's update the reporting period. Click on Dim Date on the left side of the screen, then under the Applied Steps on the right side, click on Fiscal Year and Month. You will see 12, which stands for December. Replace it with the end month number from your Excel file and press Enter. Once you are done, click on the last line under the Applied Steps to ensure everything's updated. To exit query view and load your data, go to the top left corner and click Close and Apply. Give it some time to load your new data. And that's it. With just a few clicks, you'll have a fully interactive marketing dashboard tailored to your own data. Going forward, you just need to update the Excel worksheet and click the refresh button at the top to update the dashboard with the latest data. I hope you find this marketing dashboard template helpful for your work or learning. If you are looking for more dashboard templates, be sure to check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.